Namaste, and welcome to White Chakra. The flower of life is the Akashic record of universal reality.
It's more than a coincidence that the universe is connected on an atomic level.
The seed of life represents the universal symbol of the seven phases of creation. Let's start here. Each phase represents a platonic solid and its correlating element. As the phases pass, you can see symbolism, such as the vesica Pisces, and even the tripod of life.
These platonic solids and elements are the building blocks of everything in our universe. And this is just the first set of information that is given to us from the seed of life. Also from the seed of life, the core for the flower of life soon begins to form. From the flower of life, a load of sacred information can be deciphered.
The fruit of life. Metatron's cube. The star tetrahedron. The tree of life, but most importantly, the egg of life. Look familiar? It should. It's the eight cells that formed you in embryogenesis. That's right. Every part of every person in the entire world, every animal, big and small, every sound we hear, every music note, every song and every element known to man, even some unknown to man, was based off of this symbol. I'm sure you ask yourself, why is this important? Well, I'll tell you. Every human body system that we recognize is based off of an internal
function. But we do have external body systems as well, such as our chakra system.
Do you still think it's coincidence? Well, take a look at the human body compared to the universe.
What would happen if all of the oxygen on Earth was sucked out? Or if the sun turned black? Well, before we died a horrible, excruciating death, all of our major sensory receptors would shut down. That's because majority of our senses heavily rely on outside stimuli.
It's the butterfly effect. Our actions not only affect us internally, but externally as well. Not just directly, but also indirectly.
My future vision allows me to see down the rivers of possibility, granting me insight into the possible realities our actions move us towards. But that doesn't mean I can predict everything. What I'm interested in are these extremely unlikely realities so disconnected from the natural course of events that I can't detect them. When we act in unnatural ways, we create new, unforeseen paths and arrive at these pools of improbability.
Oh, so you want to do stuff you usually don't just to see what happens?
I didn't foresee you understanding that.
So are we going to clean up that coffee?
That's what we normally do. Let's see what happens to the world when we don't. We are now dwelling in a totally new pool of improbability.
On second thought,
you probably should clean that up. There's plenty of pollution. Look at our land, our water, our wildlife,
and even our air. Our planet is dying, and Gaia is weeping and waiting for us to remember our connection to the planet.
Remember the circle of life? Well, it was more than just a Disney song, and a lot of us missed the true meaning behind it. The truth is, like our body is affected by our actions, so is our planet. And as our planet dies, leaf by leaf, so do we.
The saddest part is that nothing ever changes.
Soon, we're going to look up, and there will be nothing left.
So now what? Do I tell you to become a vegan or an environmentalist? Well, that would be awesome, but no. I just want you to wake up and wake others up. Oh yeah. And follow the golden rule. Treat others how you want to be treated, including our planet. Also, be on the lookout for my next video where I'll be discussing the Vitruvian man and human consciousness.
Namaste. And thanks for watching.
See you next time.